Carrie Ziegler Thomas. I'm an immigration attorney with Michael, Best, and Friedrich in Milwaukee, Wisconsin. And I'm here today to share some important insights regarding the Department of State's domestic visa renewal program. Now, a visa is a travel document that a foreign national has in their passport that allows them to re-enter the U.S. after travel abroad. Currently, if an individual needs a new visa or wants to renew an expired visa, they must travel to a U.S. embassy or consulate outside the United States in order to make that application. Through this pilot program, individuals who meet eligibility criteria will be able to renew their visas here in the United States without having to travel internationally. Now, the eligibility criteria for this program are all detailed on the Department of State's website. Some of the key ones are that an individual must be applying to renew an H-1B visa that was previously issued at a consulate in Canada or India between a specified time period. They must also be eligible for the interview waiver program. They must not have any visa ineligibilities. They must not be subject to a reciprocity fee. And again, all those criteria are all explained in detail on the Department of State website. Now, the applications for this pilot program will open on Monday, January 29th, with 4,000 applications accepted on that day, and continuing in February with 4,000 applications accepted on each of those days as well. I do expect that even though the criteria are fairly limited, the excitement for this program is very high. So I think those application slots will fill quickly. So individuals who think they may qualify and want to apply should apply at the earliest possible opportunity. Now, the visa fees for this program are the same as applying for a visa outside the United States. However, if an individual is deemed not to qualify, their application will be refused and the visa fee will not be refunded. A refusal will also can be counted as a visa denial, which will impact visa waiver program travel in the future. So again, those criteria should be carefully reviewed and considered. There is a navigator tool on the Department of State website that does walk individuals through the criteria to help them confirm whether or not they're going to qualify for this program. The Department of State website also has a frequently asked questions link, which describes things such as the expected processing time, which is supposed to be about 6 to 8 weeks. It also explains things such as this program is voluntary. So if someone is not sure whether or not they want to participate, they aren't required to. They can still apply for a visa at an embassy or consulate abroad. If you'd like more info on this, you can find my bio in the description below. Thank you for watching our Employment Matters vlog. Remember to subscribe for current insights and updates on important global labor and employment topics presented by the ELA. Thank you.